This video is all about working with images. Now, this is for beginners, and I have a JPEG image here. Now, if you want to get this image and kind of follow along with me, I have a link to the description. There is a website where I get these images from. It's royalty free. Anybody could use these images, so you could use this for whatever purpose that you need to use it for, or just to use it for practice. So when you open an image, again, this one I had on my Finder window, I just opened with Photoshop, and this is how I got this to be here. I want to show you some of the basic things that you could do with an image. This is the background layer. That's my image here. One of the things that I like to do is unlocking this layer. So then that'll give you more freedom to play around with this image. And to do that, you just double click this, and then you could name your layer and press OK. And there you go. Now your image is unlocked, and it gives you more flexibility with editing the image. Once your image is unlocked, let me show you some of the adjustments you can make to an image. Now, later on, we'll get a little bit more complicated with this setup and use adjustment layers and things like that. But this is just a basic overview of what you could do with a layer, like changing the exposure, changing the color and things like that. So with that layer selected, you could come to here to image and adjustment. And as you could see down here, there are a number of things you could do with an image just right off the bat using some of these adjustments. The first one being brightness and contrast. In fact, these four you see here, level, curve, exposure, those will change the exposure of your image, the level of brightness and the level of contrast. So let me just show you the first one. These all basically do the same thing, but some of these work better than the other ones, and some of them give you a lot more control. For example, I really like using curves to really get in depth with my exposure, but just for simplicity's sake, let's use brightness and contrast. And this allows you to make things darker or brighter, just like that. You just grab it and move it, or you could dial it in. And right now it's at zero, and same thing with contrast. You can make it more flat. This is more flat, meaning it's less contrasty. You see the blacks are less black. And if you go this way, it gets a lot more contrasty. The blacks get darker, the whites whiter. So that's contrast and that's brightness, just like that. Or you could press auto, and Photoshop tries to do its best to guess. I usually don't go with auto, and I usually like to use my, it did a great job here actually, and I'm gonna press okay. So that's playing with brightness and contrast. I have a different video on the Hufinity channel all about using these adjustments to change your brightness and contrast. But for now, that's how you change brightness and contrast. Next, let's look at hue and saturation. Now, saturation is the level of the vibrance of color in your overall image. So if I took saturation and went all the way up, you see everything gets really vibrant. The blues a lot bluer, even the skin tone. Obviously, it's not the right filter to use in this case at that level, but you could move it up just slightly to make your picture pop. So if you went to 25, if you look, the blues are just a lot bluer. And if you want to preview it, usually every dialog box has a check mark here. Preview, before, after. It's really kind of nice. It's making it pop. Hue, on the other hand, changes the actual color of the image. It doesn't make things more vibrant. So if I went this way, as you could see, the changes that it's making into the image. So you could play around with hue. Subtle changes here. You don't need to do anything significant. Obviously, this picture was taken with the right color temperature, and everything looks proper in this picture. So the skin tone looked great, the colors look great. So not much we need to do here. Lightness is the same thing that you had in brightness and contrast. I usually don't play around with this, and I use the brightness and contrast filter to play around with darkness and light. But for saturation, this is really nice. Let's say okay here. Now, again, back to image, adjustment. Let's look at vibrance. Now, if you remember with saturation, let me show you. If you go up with saturation, you see the skin tones really get ugly. So you don't really want to bring saturation up too much. But vibrance doesn't interfere with skin tone. So if I go up on vibrance, it doesn't interfere much with skin tone. So it makes things pop. The blue is really going to pop here. See the preview? With vibrance, you don't get those ugly artifacts that you get with saturation on skin tone. So vibrance basically is same as saturation, except it ignores the skin tone. So that's a great tool to use also. I'm just going to cancel that. Let's look at black and white. Black and white, if you wanted to make your image black and white, just like that, the black and white filter lets you do that. So it's basically getting rid of the saturation, and you could play around with some of the other settings to get the best result. Black and white's a great way to make your image black and white. I'm going to press Command Z here to bring it back. It's sort of the same with with saturation. If you take a saturation filter and take saturation to zero, you get a black and white effect, but the black and white adjustment here gives you a lot more control. So those are some of the things you could do with an image. There are some auto settings here, like auto contrast. It didn't do much here because the picture was great to begin with, but there are some auto settings here if you want to try some auto settings. And the last thing I wanted to show you with working with images is working with image size. So click image size and it will show you the image size of your documents. So if you remember image size from a different video, usually we start 1920 by 1080. This picture happens to be 1920 by 1280 at 72 resolution. You could change any of these settings if you want to. They're linked actually. So it's gonna keep the dimensions and the proportion of this picture the same. Meaning if I change this to 1000, it's gonna change the height. So if I change the width, it's gonna change the height and it's not gonna make it distorted. So if I press okay, it looks fine. So now if I press Command plus, that's basically the zoom key. Again, you could use the zoom tool to do that. I just press Command minus to bring it back. Again, if I press Command zero, it's gonna basically fit the screen. Now it's 182%, so it looks a little bit out of focus because it's bigger. The image is actually smaller than what I'm looking at, so I'm actually zooming into it. So I could press Command one, and this is the actual size of the image. So this is used to resize your image to fit your end product, basically. So if you wanna put this on social media, if you wanna put it on your website, you could use the image size to resize your image here. And you could also use, I'm just gonna show you one of the tools here, which is the crop tool here, or C. If I press the crop tool, I could come and I could drag the portion of my image I wanna keep, and I could just do that. And if I press the check mark, it's gonna crop the rest of it, meaning it's gonna lose the rest of the image. Press that. So this is the crop tool. It's really a handy tool and you just basically use it by pressing C. That's the very first one, the default crop tool. And you come in, like if I just wanted to show her face, I could come in like this and I could press okay. And there is crop the rest of it. Now I could press Command Z to go backwards. So that's how you work with image adjustments and cropping and resizing an image. In the next video, I want to show you some of these really cool filters that you could use with an image to even take these adjustments to the next level. Please give this video a thumbs up and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.